أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة
لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Beloved Muslims, dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We did not send you but a mercy to all the worlds. Allah also said, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. Indeed, you are the best nation that was sent for the goodness of mankind. So clearly, in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that being good to humanity is part of our mission. Serving the greater good of humanity is part of the mission of the Muslims. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith which was narrated by Jarir ibn Abdullah radiyallahu anhu, he said that مَنْ لَا يَرْحَمِ النَّاسِ لَا يَرْحَمُ اللَّهِ. Bukhari and Muslim recorded that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the one who does not have mercy on people, Allah will not have mercy on him. Which means that the one who show mercy to others, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have mercy on him. As clearly stated in another hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, الرَّاحِمُونَ يَرْحَمُهُمُ الرَّحْمَانُ اِرْحَمُوا مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يَرْحَمْكُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ. Ar-Rahman, the most gracious, the most merciful, will have mercy upon those who are merciful. اِرْحَمُوا مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ, have mercy upon those who are on earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have mercy on you. Dear brothers and sisters, there are no words that can express our necessity to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We cannot survive, not even for a second, without the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the mercy of Allah is the source of every good that we enjoy, every blessings that we have, and every good in which condition in which we live. So there is no word that express how necessary the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us. Any safe and secure condition in which we live is a bounty from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is a direct effect of His mercy upon us. All the bounties, all the blessings that are on earth is there by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we have seen from the previous hadith that having mercy on others is a great cause that qualifies us to have to enjoy the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if we are desirous of being dealt with in a merciful manner by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and if we desire that we be protected from evils, then the way for that is to pursue every means that qualifies us for the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is included in one ayah from the book of Allah, and that is the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّ رَحْمَةَ اللَّهِ قَرِيبٌ مِنَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Indeed, the mercy of Allah is so near from those who are al-muhsineen, those who excel in their worship of Allah and excel in their relationship with the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So being kind, compassionate, and dealing with others in a merciful manner is one great cause that will qualify us to be close from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Having ihsan towards other people is a sign that we have a mercy in our heart towards people. Dear brothers and sisters, every one of us has a share of mercy that is given to him by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are created with our shares of mercy and compassion. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defines sustenance between people, also we are given mercy by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, the share of people differ from one another. It varies. Some people have more share of mercy and kindness and compassion than others. So this is one part of the mercy that one can have. It is something that is created within us by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has given every one of us His share of mercy. However, there is another type of mercy that requires struggle and requires that we strive our best in order to acquire. So if we examine ourselves and we see lack of this good quality, which is our way to enjoy the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we have to pursue every means that make us acquire this quality and attain this good attribute that is mercy. Here are some of the means of acquiring mercy. Number one, if we realize that mercy and being merciful is part of the noble manners that Islam has encouraged people to acquire, then every one of us will strive and will do his best in order to acquire that quality. If we know and realize how much reward that is there for the people who are merciful to others, we will strive and do our best in order to acquire this mercy. If we realize how much we lose if we lack this quality, then again we will make jihad nafs, we will strive and do our best and train our best to be merciful. If we realize that al-jaza'u min jins al-amal, which is a rule, a well-established rule in Islam, that the reward or the punishment will be given the person in accordance of the type of work that he does, and therefore we find in many of the ayat and many of the ahadith affirmation of this rule. فَلْيَعْفُ وَلْيَصْفَحُ أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ لَكُمْ. So let them forgive and pardon. Don't you like that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pardon you? So this is an example from the Quran, from the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Man satara Musliman satarahu Allah. Whoever shield the Muslim, Allah will shield him. And there are many, many examples that shows that the reward that is to be given in this life and the, in the hereafter for the person will be in accordance of the type of the righteous deed that one has done or the evil deed that one has done. So if we realize this and if we know that our way to enjoy the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is by showing more mercy to others, we will starve and do our best, strive and do our best in order to acquire this this quality of mercy. If we understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded the believers to be brothers, to love one another, and to love one another and to show mercy, kindness, love and compassion to each, to towards each other, and to abstain from anything that leads to animosity or hatred between the believers, then again we will strive and do our best in order to acquire that quality. We train ourselves, we struggle in order to change whatever evil characteristics we may have in order to be as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves us to be and as our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam loves us to be. The point, dear brothers and sisters, that there is a share of mercy that we can acquire once we struggle and strive and make jihad in order to acquire that quality. It is as Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "إنما العلم بالتعلم وإنما الحلم بالتحلم." Indeed, acquiring knowledge is by seeking knowledge. You cannot say, "I want a scholar and be knowledgeable and be a scientist," and then sleep at home and wait for dreams to reveal for you the different type of sciences. Rather, you have to struggle. You have to seek knowledge. You have to study. You have to engage in every means that will lead you to be a knowledgeable and scholar person. Similarly, Rasulullah sallallahu said, "إنما الحلم بالتحلم." That in order for the person to become perseverance, one should train himself and struggle in order to have the perseverance and the forbearance that one is desiring. So there are certain things that requires efforts in our part to refine our character and to make us acquire the noble manners, including this quality of mercy. And a person strives and continues to strive to acquire that quality until his heart becomes filled with mercy, compassion, kindness, and caring for other people. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Dear brothers and sisters, being merciful is not a word that we can say and that's it, or a speech. Rather, there are certain signs for the existence of the mercy in the hearts of people. So we cannot claim that we are merciful. Rather, there should be certain signs that prove that we are merciful. This mercy that exists in the heart must reflect in the behavior and the actions that people make. If we really have mercy in our heart, That means we have a genuine and sincere desire to make good reach every human being and to protect every human being from all types of harms and evil. Dear brothers and sisters, one of the signs of the existence of that mercy in the heart of people is when people strive in order to make what is good reach every human being. And when they strive in order to protect people from any kind of evil and harm. And the best example for this is our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who said, describing himself as Imam Muslim recorded, that مَثَلِي وَمَثَلُكُمْ, and listen to this example very carefully because it is a very powerful example. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying that مَثَلِي وَمَثَلُكُمْ كَمَثَلِ رَجُلٍ أَوْقَدَ نَارًا فَجَعَلَ الْجَرَادِبُ وَالْفَرَاشُ يَقَعْنَ فِيهَا وَهُوَ يَذُبُّهُنَّ عَنْهَا وَأَنَا آخِذٌ بِحُجَزِكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ تُفْلِتُونَ مِنْ يَدَيَّ. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, my example and your example. And in this hadith, your example here refers to all humanity, because every human being is addressed by the mission of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, my example and your example is like somebody who has ignited a fire, and because of this fire, flying insects and moths started getting attracted to this fire and getting burned by this fire, and he is pushing them away from the fire. Why he was pushing them away from the fire? To protect them from falling into the fire and being burned. And he said, this is my example. I am holding to you by your waists in order to protect you from the hellfire, but you are releasing yourself and fleeing away from me. So this example illustrates how the person is, how strong of a desire every one of us should have towards other people, in caring towards other people and in making sure that they would enjoy the good that you have and they will be protected and be safe as you are. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us that even a drop of a tear could be an act of mercy if you lose someone whom you love and you shed some tears out of mercy, then this is a sign that there is a mercy that exists in your heart, as Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself did when he lost his granddaughter, and one of the companions saw him shedding some tears and he asked him. He was shocked, because in the minds of some people this could be in contradiction with perseverance and with accepting the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is not. If somebody shed some tears, I'm not talking about wailing and screaming and protesting the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, rather it is as Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said when he lost his son Ibrahim. He said, إِنَّ الْقَلْبَ لَيَحْزَنْ وَإِنَّ الْعَيْنَ لَتَدْمَعْ وَمَا نَقُولُ إِلَّا مَا يُرْضِي رَبَّنَا وَإِنَّ لِفِرَاقِكَ يَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ لَمَحْزُونُونَ. So he said that the heart feels saddened and the eye sheds tear, and but we will not say anything that show our contempt of the mercy of the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that rather we display all pleasure in accepting the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we feel sad to be separated from you, O Ibrahim, his son, saying to his son. So in the previous hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that when he was asked, what is this, O Messenger of Allah? He said, هذه رحمة يضعها الله في قلوبه في قلوب عباده وإنما يرحم الله من عباده الرحماء. That this is nothing but a mercy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instills in the heart of some of his servants. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed has mercy upon those who are merciful. So a shed of a tear is a sign of mercy. And also a kiss is a sign of mercy when you kiss your child. Show affection, compassion, kindness toward them. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam considered not kissing them is a sign of lacking the mercy in the heart. As he answered somebody who asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, should we kiss our children? I have many children, but I never kissed any of them. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, answering him, وَمَا أَمْلِكُ أَنْ أَمْلِكُ لَكَ شَيْئًا أَنْ نَزَعَ اللَّهُ الرَّحْمَةَ مِنْ قَلْبِكَ. What can I do if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken away the mercy from your heart? See how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this hadith has considered that not showing affection toward your children is a sign of lacking the mercy from your heart. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us to deal in a merciful manner and be easygoing in all our affairs, including our business transaction. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, رحم الله رجلا سمحا إذا باع سمحا إذا اشترى سمحا إذا قضى سمحا إذا اقتضى. That may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy upon the person who is easy going, who is merciful and tolerant whenever he buys or sells or do any other transaction. So this is the instruction that we have from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even in dealing with animals, all of us know the story of the prostitute that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven because of the mercy that she showed to a dog who was dying of thirst, and she said that this person is dying of thirst, and she went into the trouble of going all the way down in the well and got some water for him in her shoes and gave him, made the water available for him. Allah appreciated her mercy toward him and dealt with her in the same manner with which she dealt with that animal and has forgiven her. On the other hand, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dealt in a severe manner with some who showed cruelty towards animals. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that دخلت امرأة النار في هرة حبستها لا هي أطعمتها ولم تدعها تأكل من خشاش الأرض. That a woman entered the hellfire because of a cat that she imprisoned. She did not feed and she did not let her go to seek its own sustenance. So because of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has punished this. And as you can see that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam centuries ago told us how to treat animals. He taught us that even the good treatment of any living being is an act of charity, because the Sahaba came and asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, awalana fil an'ami ajr, are we going to be rewarded for the good treatment for our animals? And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's answer was, fi kulli kabidin ratbatin ajr, that you will have a reward in good treatment for every living being. This is how Muslims were taught centuries ago of how to deal with animals. And you know that in our current world, human rights was not really declared in a universal manner except in 1948. This is the first declaration, forget about the practice, declaration of the basic human rights. While Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not only teach us how to deal with our fellow humans, rather taught us how to deal with animals, rather with objects. If we really heed the instruction of Islam, we will be protecting our environment, we will be protecting the trees and the mountains and all living being and non-living being, because in our belief it is prohibited that we damage our environment, because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said لا ضرر ولا ضرار. It is not greed that drives Muslims, it is their belief in Allah and their expectation for their reward in the hereafter. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and I will conclude with this beautiful hadith, ما من مسلم يورث غرسا أو يزرع زرعا فيأكل منه طير أو إنسان أو بهيمة إلا كان له به صدقة. Bukhari recorded that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that whatever you plant, whether it is a tree or any kind of vegetation from which a human or animal or a bird eat, you will have a charity, it will be recorded for you as an act of charity. See this encouragement for us to plan, to build, to be merciful to all mankind, to all beings and to our environment. This is a unique aspect in our Islam that is obscured because of many reasons, and one of them our own actions. أقول قولي هذا وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن